Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. And today I'm going to answer a question. Is C++ really that bad? I deserve it. I know. So the name of this question asker is C++ Master. I think that's on his birth certificate, C++ Master. Okay, and he says, why do you say so many bad things about C++? It is the third most used programming language and the 10th most paid. Other than that, it is a pretty neat language that hasn't started stagnating and will probably grow. And then he's got additional info, C++ forever. Why do I get such a bad rap on this? Why do I give C++ such a bad rap? I've done some videos on how to learn C++, which was a trick video. You could check out the video where I talk about you shouldn't learn C++. And people get upset about this. People send me this stuff. C++ Master sends me stuff as I'm hating on C++. I gotta tell you, I have a love-hate relationship with C++. I was a big C++ person for a long time, right? I did Top Coder. You can check out my career development story, right? My personal career story. And I loved it. I still love the language. It is a very complex and elegant, yet clunky and beautiful language at the same time. There's so many contradictions in the language, right? Some of my best time that I ever had in my career coding was doing C++. So I see the beauty. I see the art in it. But when I'm advising people on this channel, I'm not advising them to follow their dreams and follow their passions and to do things for the sake of making them harder on themselves. I'm giving them pragmatic and practical advice. And so the reason why I, quote, hate on C++ so much on this channel has nothing to do with whether I think it's a good language. I think it's a great language. I think it is evolving. I think it's a superior language in many, many ways. And I think it is a valuable language, and a lot of people are making a lot of money from it. And it is a very popular programming language and will continue to exist and be popular for a long time. I believe that, truly. But if you're asking me, if you're coming to this channel and you're like, John, I want to get started as a software developer, how do I get started out? I'm not gonna say that that's the best way, right? If you really wanna go down that road, sure, go down it, fine, it's great, it's awesome. You'll definitely have a good career and you'll be a master, like C++ Master, right? It's good, you'll know more about programming than probably a lot of other people that deal with less complex programming languages. But it's already hard enough to become a software developer today, right? I wrote a book on the subject called The Complete Software Developer's Career Guide because I felt like it was so hard. You could check it out if you're interested, but I felt like it was so hard to become a software developer because there's so much information, there's so much stuff out there, right? So how do we reduce this down? How do we make this simple? And that's the whole reason why, like I said, I'm not hating on C++. It's just a matter of the fact that the easier way, right, the path of least resistance, the most practical and pragmatic way to become a developer is probably not to go down the C++ road. Now, there's some reasons why you might do that, which is fine, but in general, if you're like, John, I just want to become a software developer and I want to get started, I want to start you on something easier. I want to start you on something like Python, something that's going to be simpler and easier so that you're not going to be as frustrated and that you're going to be able to, you know, and you could be just as effective in most of those languages as you could be in C++. You know, there's places where C++ is definitely better. There's places where Rust is better, right? But in general, like for a lot of the development that's being done today, the web development, you know, mobile development, an easier language is going to serve you just as well. So that's you know, to give you an honest question again, you know, I appreciate a lot of you in that are C++ gurus. I used to be among your rank. And I respect the dedication and the work. It is a difficult, you know, you a lot of C++ developers are some of the best developers, of course, right? Because it's difficult. But I'm not gonna recommend it. I'm just not gonna recommend it to beginners because even though, you know, sometimes we can be like these battle-scarred veterans and we can wanna make, you know, the new recruits go through the same tough training and regimen that we did. But that's not always the most effective thing. It doesn't make sense. So I'm gonna do what makes sense on this channel. So there you go. Good question though. Thanks for the question. If you haven't subscribed already, click the subscribe button below. Make sure you click the bell so you don't miss any videos, especially if you're a C++ guru and you want to see when next time I'm going to bash C++, you're going to want to click that bell. All right, I'll talk to you next time. Take care.